Welcome back. Welcome back to the glorious Peak District, more specifically, Winston Lee Tor, overlooking Ladybower, Crook Hill, Wynn Hill, the list goes on. Today's walk is a relatively short one. We started from the Ashopton Viaduct back there, and we're going to head along Derwent Edge, possibly maybe to Back Tor, and then down via Lost Lad, and then along the side of Ladybower back to the bridge, the viaduct. Okay, so let's keep moving. So it's really good to be back out in the Peak District again. Towards the end of November and the first week in December, I was in Australia, Tasmania more specifically, doing the overland track, and that's a great 6 or 7 day trek depending on how long you want to take through the Tasmanian wilderness, and the last few videos on my channel will be from that adventure. So I must admit it's taken a little while to come out of the post-holiday blues and get back into the swing of things. It's now that kind of like no man's land in between Christmas and New Year. I think it's the 29th today. I have been back to work for 2 night shifts, but we're not fully back in the swing of life after the Christmas period. So it's really good to come back out into the Peak District and walk off some of the Christmas excess and get a nice breath of fresh air. And it's a beautiful day for it as well today. Absolutely stunning. There's a little bit more cloud today than there was a few days ago. I have been out walking, I've been out on the bike. My friend Ray and I did the High Peak Trail and Tissington as well. So in future, I will record that. But today, we're gonna keep moving along the Yellow Brick Road, the new path here, which thankfully, the color of it, I think it was around about maybe 2 or 3 years ago that they replaced this path here. It was bright yellow, but now it seems to have blended in to the landscape a little bit better, which is all good. There's the Great Ridge and the Vale of Edale down there, and Kinder Scout, the northern edge of Kinder's in the cloud at the moment, as is Bleaklow. But we're quite lucky here on Derwent Edge. So there's some really interesting shapes in the gritstone along this edge. Just back there was the wheelstones and salt cellar. And you can tell we're near Sheffield because there's a cakes of bread over there. Bread cakes. I think in my part of Derbyshire we call them the cobs. And it looks like there's a fire on the moor over there. Whether it's seasonal burning or not, I don't know. We're now arriving at Back Tor. So this is the Lost Lad Cairn, marked as Lost Lad on the map, and that is in memory of a lad called Abraham Lowe. And I think the story goes that he was a shepherd boy, and I think he'd come up onto the moors to gather in the sheep, and a storm closed in, a winter storm, and he sheltered under a rock, under a little overhang, and I think he wrote the words Lost Lad, he engraved it into the rock, and because of the bad weather, the snow drifted up, he got his dog with him as well, the sheepdog, and I think he was around about 3 months until the snow had gone before he was found. So I think the legend goes that every shepherd that passed the cairn back there put another rock on top. But there are lots of different stories and legends as well. I think people have claimed to have seen a young lad wandering the moors with a dog, a ghostly figure. But quite interesting and quite sad at the same time. So we've come down off Derwent Edge now, down from Lost Lad, and we're heading towards Mill Brook, I think it's Far Deep Clough, and then back down to the Ladybower Reservoir near the old Derwent village. So we've just had lunch overlooking the Derwent Reservoir. Just in the background there is the dam wall. Once again, we can see the great ridge in the distance there. It's absolutely beautiful out here today. The weather's perfect, really. It's not too cold either. Even though I've put my hat on, I think it's because we're sat down for a while having lunch, but it's not really like winter. It has been quite cold over the last few days. We've had like thick frost, but no sign of any snow at the moment. Who knows, possibly in January we'll get a little bit. But I must admit, I'm looking forward to more daylight hours and the signs of spring. So we're now heading down the final little descent here to the Ladybower Reservoir. And we're gonna be walking along the path that runs along the eastern side. So we've just come out of the gate there, down and round. So this is the site of the old Derwent village, and on the sign back there you may have seen the picture of the church steeple, which used to stick out of the water, but I think they used explosives to get rid of it back in the 60s, I think, but don't quote me on that one. Health and safety reasons as well. But when the river, or the reservoir rather, is low, you can still see signs of the old village. My friend Andy and I came here on the bikes just over a year ago, and you can still go across the old bridge and things like that. So we're now back at the Ashopton Viaduct, back down at the Snake Road, and it's been a really great walk. Only a short one, it's about 8.5 miles, and it's taken us around about 3.5-4 hours. We've stopped for lunch for about 20 minutes, but I've been stopping and taking photos and things like that. But it's been really enjoyable and really great to be back in the Peak District, the glorious Peak District once again. The videos that I was talking about earlier from Tasmania will be just before this video on my channel. I'll add a link at the end as well to it, but normal service will resume. Walking, hiking, camping, cycling in the Peak District and beyond. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time. Bye for now.